Ni hao. Welcome back to the Wudang School. We are a school of the Wudang Sanfengpai, promoting Taoist culture, philosophy, and martial art practice. I'm the translator of the school. We are now back onto our interview with the Grandmaster, Shi Ye. And in the second half of the interview, we had questions concerning training and cultural understanding. In this particular episode, we have asked the question, apart from the Tao Te Ching, what other Taoist sources are important in learning Taoist culture? And in the Sanfengpai, is there a particular learning order for those things? Now, instead of directly addressing this question, Shi Ye brought up something much more interesting, talking about the order in which training is done. Let's look at the answer.
道家文化还有哪一些重要的经典在三峰派有没有特定的一些学习的顺序经典这个不是我们这个派的经典是我们道家的从道家过来然后有道教以后道教把道家的经典拿来作为修这位学习的 作为这么讲是日常修炼的学习的这么一些精髓是吧经典我们说的那实际上练功里我们说的这个修炼的方法呢内容很多不管它是什么样的内容但是修炼它一定有步骤的第一个是什么呢就是人要练由外而来 现代的人符合这个练法就是先练形后练意形是什么呢我们的形体不过我们形体怎么样去改变呢你身体的柔韧性对吧柔韧性很重要的因为道家它最终是天人合一它的思想它有返老还童返璞归真第一个返璞归真第一个返老还童是身体体型上面的返老还童又做到什么呢柔软柔弱 柔软与童子，跟婴儿一样，是吧？专气致柔，婴儿乎，是吧？就跟婴儿一样，这种柔。那身体从一个僵硬的一个状态，要变得很柔，那他的思想和他的情绪都平静下来，那也就柔乎下来了。那为人处事上面，他就有包容，那就是体型的这种改变，是吧？首先就是什么柔韧性，他的平衡。 他的协调，对不对？那这些东西是他们的基础，那这是肯定是第一步要做到的。第二个就是调整自己的身心，是吧？就是情绪和你思想上面，是吧？又得到一个提升。第三步呢什么呢？就是修心性，啊，心性就是养神了，开始。神为身体为主宰，把神养满了，把自己的神精神养足了。 对不对？他气就足，有很多人反过来了，老师就补气，气虚，神不足的人补不了气。因为我们是学过这个道医、学个中医的人，我们懂这个东西。人家过去叫十道九医，对不对？修道人都懂医，所以我明确的告诉我们学生，气虚你补不了，补不了。他现在人给过去人气虚不同，对吧？我们中国人很清楚，我们在六七十年代以前就没有吃的。 这个人一虚了，你给他搞几片人参，蒸一个什么鸡蛋或什么的，一吃马上精神就来了。那这个时候的人的精神是很简单的，对不对？他没有什么精神消耗，因为他没有什么吃的，没有什么可玩的，没有东西可以去耗他的思想。他天一黑了，他就睡觉了，对不对？天一亮他就起床了，就什么叫日出而作，而落而息。他是没有特别复杂的思想，他的神耗的时候，他缺的是什么营养？ 所以他气血虚，他补气是比较快的。你现在的人呢，那个人参呢，补气嘛，对吧？人参补气，你用玩熬的喝，他也补不了气。黄芪补气补的还上火，对不对？没有用，为什么没有用啊？对不对？神没有补嘛，你不养神怎么能补到气呢？因为神为主宰嘛，对不对？所以我刚才前面讲了，我说很多人他疲劳，他不知道为什么他疲劳。 他不明白为什么疲劳，是因为他不知不觉地耗了神了。 我们叫思虑神，就是思想太复杂了，想的太多了，对不对？啊，忧虑太多了，所以他就伤了自己的神，然后神伤的就很糟糕，对不对？那是个很可怕的事情，对不对？一直在找自己的这个问题出在哪里，一直找不出来，这就是现在这种现象。现在我们现在叫十个九虚，十人九虚，包括现在孩子青少年都虚，有什么办法？因为他耗的太多了，天天手机拿手上，天天看，天天耗，晚上不睡觉玩手机，对不对？十二点了还不睡，所以这个我们这个步骤告诉他步骤是很清楚的。那我们过去这个道家有个这个植物流注，十二时辰嘛，植物流注，什么时候该起床了，什么时候该睡觉了，什么时候该吃饭了，什么时候该午休了，对不对？他教你怎么样去做，他很清晰的去告诉你，对吧？那他有步骤。所以练功它也是步骤，先从身体上面的改变来树立自己的自信心啊，我身体变柔软了，好了，比以前舒服了，没那么柔了，没那么僵了，身体的这个循环也好了，我的心情自然就开心，心情开心了以后情绪就平了，情绪一平了以后我的思想就平静了，思想平静了以后我静得下来了，我就能养神了，我神养好了以后，对不对？我精气神就饱满了，我耗得少了，是不是回归了回到孩童的这个时期来了，对不对？然后再慢慢的，最后了，再把思想返老还童，就是把人的思想再平静下来，简单化，然后就注意了这个开始长智慧了，所以它有步骤，
Okay, so in response to our question regarding literature, Siye has pointed out that the literature does not belong to our particular lineage. It is not a Sanfengpai book or scripture. It is Taoist culture, and from those reading, we understand the culture. Now, since it has been mentioned, the learning order, and Siye continues to explain the issue of the order of training. And training has a broad variety of methods, but note that any method necessarily has steps, the 步骤. Now for us, the first is we do the training from external to internal, and this is explained as 先练形后练意. First, practice an external shape, and from that, we practice the mind. First, we focus on flexibility of the body, stretching, basic stances, and so on. The Taoist philosophy states that we pursue the heaven and human in unity, 天人合一, 返老还童, 返璞归真. So, return to the infant state, return from the complicated to the simple. First part of the body and the qi be like an infant. Body changes from stiff to soft. Thinking and emotion also become calm. Then in one's action, one shows 包容, which means to have a more inclusive mindset. And you have softness, balance, and harmony in thinking. The second step is to adjust one's emotion and thinking following the physical training, the external stuff. And the third, cultivate the mind. 心性, rest the spirit, 养神. So in contrast to what was described in the above, and many people actually have the order reversed, and they try to focus on 补气, to cultivate the qi for the body. Those who lack in mind, in fact, cannot cultivate qi. So, Shiye says that people used to say 十道九医, that means out of 10 Taoist practitioners, 9 of them know medicine. And Taoists, they have studied Chinese medicine, and from that knowledge, they know this cannot be done. Modern people lacking in qi is quite different from the old time. So Shiye said, for example, in the 60s to the 70s in mainland China, if someone is weak in the body, lacking qi, give him some ginseng or egg, It helps him to recover very efficiently. People in the old days were quite simple. When the sun goes up, they get up and go to school, go to work. When the sun goes down, they go to sleep. There have not been particularly complicated thoughts. So the mind power is not overly consumed. What they lack was nutrition. Hence, if they have a deficiency in energy, lack in qi, to replenish, it is very fast. Nowadays, when people take ginseng or some kind of nutrition to nurture qi, it doesn't help. Then what is the issue? Why is it useless? Because the mind has not been resting. If the mind is not cultivated, it's not possible to replenish qi. As said, nowadays many people feel tired and they don't know why. And they try to take nutrition and try to do things, they still feel tired. Because they have too many troubles on the mind, the mind has not been replenished. And if the mind power is depleted, you still feel tired, it doesn't matter what you do to the body. And this harm has been a terrible issue. That's why nowadays the saying, 十人九虚, out of 10 people, 9 people are weak inside. Including young people, looking at the phone all the time, not sleeping late at night, worrying about things constantly. So in the process of training, just to recap, first, body becomes flexible. People become more confident in themselves, and the circulation of the body improves, so the body overall feels more comfortable. Then one feels content and can enter serenity to be calm. And so the mind can be still, hence one is able to rest and cultivate the mind. Having done that, the energy is sufficient and there is not so much consumption. Is it not returning to the state of the infant then? Lastly, return the thinking to infant state, think simple. Then one is ready to pursue wisdom. So you see, training has steps. So that was the translation to the answer given by the grandmaster. Now in all the translations, we try to stay as close as possible to the original message. Where needed, we have put translation on the screen for you to read. In the next one, we will come back to martial art training, in which the grandmaster explains the difference between Tai Chi and Liang Yi. We will see you in the next video.